Hello, everybody. With me today is a leader of the pack, and you are watching Oakland Tobacconist. If you'd like to try this cigar, as well as any other of Stallone's offerings, go to oaklandtobacconist.com, and that is where you can find the entire portfolio. So, I wanted to do a special review, and that is of the Stallone Connecticut. This is special to me because Stallone is known for that strength, the amount of flavor, sometimes pepper, that can be right out the gate. So, when you try something like their Negro Maduro, which is a medium plus, you try their San Andreas, which is full, or you try their Broadleaf, which is even fuller to me, they've got their You try their Broadleaf, which is even fuller to me. You got their Corojo, which is in that medium to medium plus, and their Habano medium. What is it like when Stallone, a company that is known for strength, creates a Connecticut cigar? And that is what we are smoking today. I have the Palomino Connecticut Robusto. This is going to be a very interesting tasting and review for me because I have not smoked this for quite some time. When I did smoke it, it was in Nevada. And it was, being at a lower elevation, you had a lot more pepper and a lot more of a kick behind it. I want to see how it does here at our shop. We're going to go ahead and light this up and we're going to see where it lands us. I'm gonna also kind of see on the cold draw. Connecticut's and mild cigars typically are not in my wheelhouse. I prefer something that's more gonna give a sort of a kick and a strength level. I wanna see how this is gonna do just on the palate and see where it's gonna land us. So I'm gonna go ahead and start cutting this up and try with a cold draw. I'm gonna snip off the end right there. A little bit of hay and a little bit of nuttiness. So we're gonna go ahead and get this toasted, lit up, and see where it lands us. Now, once again, when lighting up and toasting a Connecticut cigar, it is very important to try to toast your cigar without scarring the wrapper. The wrapper is very silky, very thin. You don't want to actually scar the wrapper and get it all burnt because you're going to lose some of that taste. All right. So, right at light up. This produces a ton of smoke output. You can kind of see it here on the camera. It's producing a lot of smoke, very silky smoke, but it does have that kind of like New World Connecticut, San Latano Connecticut, Rosa Sharon kind of kick to it in the beginning. I will say there is a small hint of pepper, very, very minimal, not much. A lot of that nuttiness, but let me go ahead and see what it kind of is. Now it's regulated. We'll see kind of our first couple of flavor impressions. Okay, again, a lot of those silky flavor notes, a lot of that that nuttiness that's coming in. It's burning a little bit uneven, but I think that's more of how I started smoking it as I kind of toasted it, so I'm sure that's gonna regulate out. This wrapper leaf is very, very rustic in a way. It's got some like bumps to it. It's got a little bit of veins to it. Not at all off-putting. I think it actually adds to just the rustic nature of Stallone, the Palomino Connecticut. There's a small tingling on my tongue that suggests something like pepper or saltiness. But really good flavors so far. Something I noticed as well is that it's very creamy on the retro. There's like no pepper on the retro, so that's really smooth, very easy. But it's got a lot going on. And as I say, for a smoker like myself who prefers medium plus the full body, it's keeping my interest really well. It's actually drawing me back to explore some of those flavors. Typically, you'll hear that term where people say, I want a really smooth cigar. So oftentimes, not every time, but people will move to something like a Connecticut, Ecuadorian Connecticut shade. And that is because it offers a filtration system from sunlight. Connecticut shade means that they grow it under cheesecloth, and the strength of the sun is being filtered so that it doesn't completely go directly to the leaf. The reason most Connecticuts, or at least a high volume of Connecticuts, are grown in Ecuador is because there's a natural cloud coverage. So because of all those cloud coverage, it's already naturally filtering the sun, which gives it a good benefit to the wrapper itself. Ecuador has good soil for this sort of thing, so that's why a lot of them you see Ecuadorian Connecticut. So when you have something like a Nicaraguan Connecticut, you run the risk of having the silkiness, the creaminess, the nuttiness foreshadowed by the strength of the Nicaraguan tobacco. So you either go with very low primings or very mellow tobaccos for your fillers and binder, and then you end up with a very smooth, easy on the palate, something very light. But then for someone who wants a bit more of a kick, it's sort of finding that balance between the Nicaraguan tobaccos and the Ecuadorian Connecticut shade. This, right now, as it starts out, has that creaminess, that nuttiness, but also a small amount of punch, as I had mentioned, that tingling on my lips and tongue. So there's a lot going on, and I want to see how this continues. So that is the first third of this Palomino Connecticut. We will see what happens when we get into the second third. Okay, getting into the second third, this thing's got a lot going on. Along with that nuttiness, that creaminess, it's still got this like back end, like medium to, I don't want to say medium plus, that might be too much, but medium strength in nicotine, but there's more sweetness. So as I'm going down through this cigar, I'm not getting any like harsh notes, I'm not getting any tones that are more like peppery, but there is a sweetness as I continue through it, and I think that's more of the wrapper. And I will say too, I have not touched this thing up once. The razor sharp burn is great. The ash is rather dark, but the burn rate of all the tobaccos, that's your filler, your binder, and the wrapper, is burning perfectly all together in unison. And there's more of that sweetness coming forward. So I'm really, really enjoying this. I can see this really popping with some maybe like cream soda, maybe a coffee, or even it probably can stand up with more like of a sweeter bourbon to help kind of balance out the sweetness and some of the other flavors that are happening. But I bet if you were to go with a bitter coffee, the contrast of that bitterness would bring that subtle sweetness from the cigar to the front, which would be a really interesting thing. But definitely in the medium range, there is the term in the industry, not your grandfather's Connecticut. And typically that's like, you know, this Connecticut's gonna be strength, it's gonna be full, it's gonna really satisfy you on the strength level, but you will run the risk of losing the sweetness from the Connecticut wrapper leaf. That's not what's happening here. I'm gonna say it's more of a mild to medium, probably more of a medium range, that nicotine hits on the back end. The smoke output is really great still, but I'm enjoying the sweetness off of the wrapper of this Connecticut cigar. This has definitely got a lot going on, and as you can kind of see, smoke output is amazing. I know there's a lot of times when you light up a cigar and it's a bit unfortunate because you're getting some of the flavors, but the smoke output is just very minimal at best. That is not the case with this Connecticut. I'm enjoying it. It has not lost its ash. It continues to go strong, and I love the sweetness that I'm getting off of this Connecticut wrapper. So I'm gonna continue to smoke this. We're gonna smoke through and get to the final third, but I'm really enjoying it now, so I'm gonna see where that's gonna land us. All right, guys, coming into the final third, it still has that sweetness, it still has that flavor punch, and it's not getting bitter at all. Sometimes you run the risk with Connecticuts, the closer you get down to that band, the closer that you get down to the end of the cigar, that you have this like signature Connecticut bitterness. That's not what's happening in the Stallone. It's very sweet, it's got a lot going on, it's holding that flavor, and I'm enjoying the complexity of difference. Sort of that sweetness that stays there, the nuttiness that's more coming forward as well. It's just really enjoyable. When I think of something that I want when I hear not your grandfather's Connecticut, it's something like this. Complex, flavor interesting, not too smooth where I have a good mouthfeel, good smoke output, and it's delivering those things. I had to lose the ash. I was moving from one place to the other and unfortunately it fell off. I just got rid of the lower band there. But I'm really, really enjoying it. This is a Connecticut for someone like myself, or even for someone who enjoys lighter cigars, that it can kind of fit that bill, that palate. If you have any questions or your own experience with the Stallone, I would love to hear them. Drop it down in the comments and I'll get right back to you. As always, I'm Eric and you have been watching Oakland Tobacconist.